Concrete is a key building block for infrastructure, such as roadways, bridges, buildings, and other landmarks. It has been used for over 100 years as a durable, long-lasting material for paving applications ranging from residential streets to interstate highways. Concrete is made of paste and aggregates, or rocks. The paste that binds aggregates is made of cement and water. When first placed, the mixture is plastic, but soon a chemical process known as hydration begins, causing the paste to harden and transforming the mixture into a hard, durable, rock-like material known as concrete. Aggregates such as sand, gravel, or crushed stone typically make up 60 to 75% of concrete by volume and 70 to 85% of concrete by weight. Aggregates are more than just filler and are essential ingredients that strongly affect the characteristics and performance of concrete. Aggregates used in concrete can be divided into two broad categories, fine and coarse. Fine aggregates consist of natural sand or crushed stone passing through the 3/8-inch sieve, but mostly less than 0.2 inches and retained on the 200 sieve. Coarse aggregates consist of gravel or crushed stone, generally greater than 0.2 inches, and typically range from 3/8-inch to 1.5 inches. Aggregate characteristics that affect concrete properties include gradation and voids, durability and soundness, shape and surface texture, abrasion and skid resistance, absorption and surface moisture. The majority of aggregate used in concrete comes from gravel and crushed stone. Natural gravel and sand are usually dug or dredged from a pit, river, lake, or seabed. Crushed stone is produced by crushing quarry rock, boulders, cobbles, or large gravel.
Traditionally, there was quite a bit of river gravel also used in the production of concrete. But there becomes a scarcity of these natural resources over time. And I think the tendency in the marketplace is that the crushed limestone is emerging as the more common coarse aggregate.
Aggregates should meet the requirements of AASHTO M6 and M80. These specifications define the requirements for gradation and quality of fine and coarse aggregate for use in concrete by limiting the permissible amounts of deleterious substances. Aggregates must be clean, hard, and strong. They must be free of absorbed chemicals, coatings of clay, or other fine materials in amounts that could affect bonding or hydration of the cement paste. After harvesting, aggregates are processed by crushing, screening, and washing to obtain proper cleanliness and gradation. Care must be taken in the handling and storing of aggregates to minimize segregation, degradation, and contamination. It is not sufficient to describe an aggregate by its maximum and minimum size because the particle size distribution affects the concrete's characteristics. Therefore, gradation limits are specified by agencies for a range of sieve sizes.
Well, first of all, we check the size of the stone in our QC lab. We check the different quantities of the size aggregate that are required to be in the stone.
Gradation is the particle size distribution of an aggregate as determined by a sieve analysis performed using wire mesh sieves with square openings. The procedure for sieve analysis is detailed in AASHTO T27, with sieve opening sizes listed in AASHTO M6, M80, and M43. Tolerances for dimensions of sieve openings are listed in AASHTO M92. The gradation and gradation limits are expressed as the percentage of material passing each sieve. Historically, in the U.S., coarse aggregate gradation and fine aggregate gradation were typically specified separately, without addressing the gradation of the overall system. While this is useful for managing stockpiles of coarse and fine aggregate, it is the combined gradation that is critical for performance. In the 1990s, pioneering work by Shilstone led to the development of the Workability Factor Chart for the combined gradation. The chart was based on field experiments and experience with a focus on reducing segregation in mixtures. The combined gradation of the aggregate affects the void content of the concrete mixture. Denser gradation results in decreased void content by improving packing efficiency. The combined gradation, maximum aggregate size, and void content affect relative aggregate proportions and also cement and water requirements. These proportions affect uniformity, workability, stability, pumpability, economy, porosity, and shrinkage of the concrete mixture, which in turn affects durability, long-term performance, and smoothness. For paving concrete, an optimized gradation as represented by the Tarantula Curve is an effective way of combining aggregate particles to achieve the desired mixture properties. The Tarantula Curve establishes the boundaries for the percent of aggregate particles retained on various sieve sizes to minimize segregation and ensure good workability. Physical durability problems can occur with aggregates susceptible to repeated cycles of freezing and thawing, or wetting and drying, and associated volume changes. Aggregates are considered unsound if these volume changes lead to the deterioration of concrete. Volume changes associated with wetting and drying are very rare. As such, soundness primarily pertains to freeze-thaw resistance, as tested using ASHTO T161 and T103. Many agencies use ASHTO T104 to test for aggregate soundness and resistance to disintegration by sulfates. This test simulates weathering due to freezing and thawing. Chemical durability problems can occur due to reactions between the aggregate and other materials, such as some of the components with cement. The reactivity is potentially harmful only when it produces significant expansion and related cracking. A majority of chemical durability problems result from a reaction between reactive silica contained in the aggregates and alkalis in the cement. An aggregate's susceptibility to this durability problem, called alkali-silica reaction, ASR, can be evaluated using ASHTO T303 and other ASTM standards. Some aggregates, such as fine-grained dolomitic limestones with large amounts of calcite, clay, or silt, can be susceptible to expansive alkali carbonate reactivity. The shape and surface texture of the aggregate primarily influences the workability of the fresh concrete. Rough-textured, angular, elongated particles increase the void content between particles, requiring more water to produce workable concrete as compared to smooth, rounded, compact aggregates. Thus, they require more cementitious content to maintain the same water to cementitious materials ratio. Aggregates should be relatively free of flat and elongated particles where the ratio of length to thickness exceeds a specified value. An indirect method of establishing a particle index as an overall measure of particle shape or texture is provided in ASTM D3398. Aggregates play an important role in determining the resistance of concrete to surface abrasion and wear. A good aggregate is hard, dense, and strong, and free of soft, porous, or friable particles. Aggregate resistance to abrasion and degradation can be tested by the Los Angeles Abrasion Test, ASHTO T96. Harder aggregates should be selected in highly abrasive conditions to minimize wear. Absorption and surface moisture of aggregate are determined using ASHTO T255. As the internal structure of aggregate is made up of solid material and voids that may or may not contain water, the amount of water in the concrete mixture has to be adjusted to include the moisture conditions of the aggregate. Manufactured aggregate is derived from the byproducts of other manufacturing processes. The production of manufactured aggregate requires varying degrees of processing depending on the materials being used. The properties of manufactured aggregates can also vary considerably depending on the materials. Expanded shale, expanded clay, and expanded slate lightweight aggregate is prepared by expanding select minerals in a rotary kiln at temperatures over 1800 degrees Fahrenheit. Manufactured lightweight aggregate has a lot of voids in the aggregate particle such that it allows moisture to be retained.
It puffs up like a popcorn-like material and has a lot of air voids in it, which gives it its lightweight quality.
Internally cured concrete, pre-wetted expanded shale, clay, or slate lightweight aggregate is used to replace some of the conventional sand to supply additional curing water throughout the concrete mixture. Recycled concrete aggregate, also known as RCA, is made up of old concrete from sidewalks, pavements, curbing, and building slabs. After removal, the concrete is processed by crushing the concrete into smaller pieces and then screened. The screening process sizes the crushed concrete. Any leftover steel pieces are removed before being used as aggregate. Aggregates can also be recycled or reclaimed from other sources, such as recycled asphalt pavement, also known as RAP.
So we can use recycled aggregates or reclaimed aggregates in concrete. We can also use it as base material, and if we grind it up fine, we can even use it as a replacement for fine aggregates. So this trend of using recycled aggregates is a very strong trend that supports all of our sustainability goals.
RCA generally has a higher absorption and a lower specific gravity than conventional aggregate. RCA may also contain chlorides from roadway de-icing salt application. High chloride levels can cause corrosion of the steel within the concrete. However, the quantity of chloride typically found in old concrete pavement is low and not a significant concern. Studies have shown that all things being equal, the modulus of elasticity and flexural strengths of concrete using RCA and RAP are typically lower than those for concrete containing virgin aggregate. As with any new aggregate source, recycled and reclaimed aggregates should be tested for durability, gradation, and other properties. Aggregates comprise much of the bulk and as such are an essential component of concrete. Choosing the proper aggregates combined into the proper gradation is crucial to producing a workable and consistent concrete mixture that is economical and durable.